We'll come back to the next session on microcontroller and embedded system laboratory. Now we'll discuss on program 8 program, write program, count number of ones and zeros in two consecutive memory location. So nothing but two consecutive memory location, you have to read data and count it, how many number of binary ones and binary zeros are there. Here ones and zeros meaning is how many binary ones and binary zeros are there, that you have to count it. Nothing but two consecutive memory location, nothing but we are working with a 16 bit number. Okay, if it is four consecutive, 32 bit number. Okay. That is the main thing now. Okay. Nothing but you have to use the copy the 16 bit number. Now I will come to the program part. So how many variables are required? This is my first variable which is stored in the ROM. Okay. So I am using the binary data, so easy to know that how many ones and zeros, or you can easily to write that, or you can easily come to know that whether correctly numbers are counted or not. Okay. In RAM, I declare two variables, zeros and ones. We'll keep the it'll keep the count of ones and zeros. So nothing but after counting, it will store it into the these two variables. Okay. Now we can start. So how many binary numbers are you are counting? 16 binary numbers you are counting. 16 numbers. Okay, that we are working with 16 bit number. Okay. That's why R0 will count 16 bit. Then load the number into R2. Keep in mind that if you write only LDR, it will copy 32 bit number. But you should copy only 16 bit number. Say LDRH. So that's why I am used here align. Okay. If you remove the align, you will get the, it will copy 32 bit number. Okay, that is the main problem here. Or you will get the error statement. I'll show the error statement later on. Okay. Then how you can count binary ones and zeros? By using your barrel shifter instruction, logical shift right or logical shift left, rotate, you can use it. Okay, so which instruction I have to use, whether I have to shift right or shift left. Okay. Now look at that R1, LSL left shift. How many times you are shifting? Only one time you are shifting it. Why are you shifting one time? We need to check that whether it is binary 1 or 0 after shifting. Okay, but how to come to know that that number is 1 or 0? Someone need to inform you. That is information we can get from your CPSR. Okay, if you know the working of logical shift left, the MSB bit first copied to the carry flag bit. Okay. And the shift. So on when it is shifting towards left side, each bit first copy into carry, then go out. Okay. And from right side, zero is appended. Similarly, in right shift, the LSB is copied into the, or copy of LSB kept in carry flag bit. Then remaining bits are shifted towards the right side. And from the left side, zero is appended. Okay. Now, whether it will help logical left shift, we can check that one. Now look at this. These are, and keep in mind that you are working with the 16 bit number. Now, after execution, it does not affect your CPSR. Reason for that, it why it not affected CPSR is, this is the reason. Can observe that. I'll go back. Now check the content of R1. Carefully observe that. Check the content of R1. Now the lower four digits are 00, higher four digits are 00, and lower four digits are 0F0F0F. You are counting 1s and 0 for lower 16 bit, not the higher 16 bit of resistor R1. So that's why we can't shift towards left side. We need to shift towards right side. If you shift towards left side 16 times, we'll get 0 only. Okay, 0s are 0s only, 1s are 0s only. So that's why we shift towards right side. Okay. Now, I'll change the. I'll do the change in that, and we can observe that. Now I can observe that the CPSR get changed. Carry flag is now set to 1. Okay, now here after shifting towards right side, the carry flag is affected. Okay. But in the left side shifting, it does not affect it because we are concentrating on lower 16 bit. We are not concentrating on higher 16 bit. Okay. Now we have to repeat this and count each how many each binary number, how many zeros are, then how many ones are. So we need the counter for this. Okay. I'll stop debug. So I'll use the two register R2. I'll use to keep the count of zeros, and R3 I'll use the keep the count of ones. Okay. Now, after shifting towards the right side, the carry flag is set or not. If carry flag is set, meaning that binary number is 1. If carry flag is 0, then that binary number is 0. So if carry flag is 1, increment the content of R2 by 1. Otherwise meaning is that it's 0. So R3 should increment by 1. So how we can check that one? By using branch instruction. By branch if carry set, then we can write once add is a label name, nothing but R2, where R2 had to increment it by 1, nothing but add it by 1. If condition fails nothing but the R3 should add it by 1 or increment by 1. So I'll use add R3, R3, #1. Okay, then I'll put the label name once add, where I'll write add R2, R2, #1. Okay, so I'll put the comment R3 to keep count of zeros, then R2 will keep the count of ones. Okay, that become easier. Now you are rotated how many times, that also you need to keep the track of it. So as your R0 will keep the track of it, so subtract R0 by 1, R0, #1. Okay, so now after now when I have to rotate how many times till that R0 becomes 0, then I have to stop it because you are only checking the 16 bit binary number. So we can write branch if not equal, then next. Nothing but check the next binary number. Now first one number one times shifted towards right. Check that binary number is 1 and 0 with the help of carry flag bit. Then according to that, increment the count of ones or count of zero. Not both. Keep in mind, not simultaneously should be incremented. If it is 1, R2 should be incremented. If it is 0, R3 should be incremented. Okay, that we keep in mind that. Then where I have to write the next label now? Next label I have to write move, because this instruction, with the help of this instruction only we can rotate also and you can check the carry flag. Okay, so I'll write here next. Okay, now carefully observe that. Now if it is carry, it will move to the ones and increment the R2 count. If condition fails, the R3 count will be incremented by 1 or add by 1. Okay, but problem, carefully observe that. Now problem arises, will 1 by 1 will come to that. Okay, so this is the program. Okay, I'll save this one. So I have to repeat this till all 16 numbers are rotated, shifted towards right side and counted ones and zeros. Okay. Now translate, debug. One more thing is remaining, that after counting, we need to store these values of R2 and R3 in ones, R3 in zeros. Okay, this in the memory I have to store it. Okay, so for that we'll use again load and store instruction. Okay, and right here LDR get the address of memory variable zeros into register. We already used R0, R1, R2, R3. Go for R4 now. R4 comma equal zeros. Then with the help of str containing zeros, nothing but we R3 are using it, copy it into memory pointed by R4. Okay. Similarly in LDR R5 is to copy the number of ones. Again str which R2 are using it, comma and square bracket R5. Okay. So this last four instruction will copy the content of R2 and R3 in the respective variable zeros and ones. Okay, this way I copied it. Save it again. Translate. So there is no zero error and zero warning. As if you remove the align, I'll comment it align now. Translate it, now I get one warning, add 2 bytes of padding at address 0x36 at line number 19, here only. Okay, nothing but the padding is required, 2 more bytes you have to add it, nothing but treating this as a 32-bit number. It not treating this as a 16-bit number, so we need to align. Okay, if you keep the align, it will consider this, we are working with the 16-bit number. Okay. Now, come to the debug. Now I'll increment all goals step by step. Now keep observing all the content of register R0, R1, R2, R3. Until you can observe this part up to. Because next these are only you are storing into the in the variable zeros and ones. Okay. Then your number is your this is RAM. 4 7 zeros. We are in RAM, memory 2 is RAM, memory 1 is ROM. Okay. Now ROM, no need to run the ROM, the number is stored here, your number at memory location 34 0f0f. Okay, you can go any binary number also, but I am using 0f0, easy to keep the count of ones and zeros. Okay. Now R0 become 10 because 10 is hexadecimal. In decimal it is 16. Okay, nothing but 16 number you are counting. Now you have copied the number from memory genome, that is 0f0. Then you have rotated it, also affect the carry flag bit. Okay, if the carry flag is 1, then you should R2 should be added 1 and R0 should be kept 0. There is no change in the R3 because R3 is used to count only zeros. Okay. Now we can observe that R2 is incremented by 1, now it become 1, now nothing but 1 binary number we have got it, that is logic 1. Similarly, I'll shift towards right side, you can keep on observing that. Now R2 again incremented, again R2 again incremented, again R2 incremented, nothing but you have counted these 4 ones, okay, which is stored here in R2. Okay, now move on to the next one. Still, because still R0 is not 0, still the 4 bits are counted out of 16 bits, so still 12 bits are remaining. Okay. Now carefully observe that. Now carry flag is now become 0, we can observe that here, carry flag becomes 0. We should increase the count of R3, not the count of R2. We should only increase the count of R3, not the R2. Keep in mind that. Okay, and move on to next step. R3 is now become 1, absolute no problem, and there is no change in the R2. Okay, now I'll go for next step. R2 is now become 5, nothing but R2 not only keeping the count of ones also and also keeping the count of zeros. This is not the our aim, this is not satisfy the aim of the experiment. Okay, so what we can do it now? So in that case, we can observe that there is logical error in your program. Okay, what that error now? That error is here the logical error exists. Okay. After execution of this instruction, add R3, R3, 1, which will be the next instruction? Next instruction is add R2, R2, 1. Okay, nothing. This addition R3 is for counting zeros and R2 is for counting ones. But after counting zeros, it counting one also get incremented. It should not increment it. So for that, we have to keep one unconditional branch instruction. So that counting both the adding one to the each counter, the only add to the R3 should not add to the R2. It should directly go to the subtract R0, 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 1, nothing but you have done the how many number of counting, how many binary number you have checked it. Okay, I'll write here branch only B. I'll put that label name as you can use next. Okay. Oh, okay. I'm sorry. Already you are using next, so you have to use next bin. You can make it bin next binary number. I'll use here this label. I'll change to next bin. Next bin means binary number. Okay. I'll use here next now. So nothing but after adding one to the R3. That will directly go to the this label name next now. So it will skip this one now. And this instruction is used only when carry is 1. This instruction is used only when carry is 0. Okay. Now it become there is no incrementing of both the counters now. Okay. Now carefully observe that. Now look at R2, now look at only R2 and R3, only these two resistors. Okay. Now R2 is 2, R2 is 3, R2 is 4, now R2 is not 5. Okay, now because as the R3 is now increment because now counting zeros now. This 4 has completed now. Now we are here now. Now I am here. Okay. Now I shifted towards, these bits are shifting towards right side. Okay. These are shifting towards right. Okay. Now you can observe that R3 is now become 2, 3, 4. Now again R2 is become 5 because now we are here now. Here. Okay, now these four ones we are counting it. Okay. Also keep the content of R0 is 0 or not. Okay. Now R2 is become 8. Now incrementing the R3. Now I am here now. Okay. Now R3 is become now 8. R2 is 8, R3 is 8. Nothing but all number you have counted it. And your R0 is 1. So I'll put next one, it becomes 0. Now you have to stop your. Now you have to copy the content of R2 and R3 to the RAM. Okay. Even you have copied here and show in RAM. You can observe that here. Okay, here 8 is copied. The content of R3 is copied to this memory. Zeros are copied. Now next instruction executed. Now I copied the number of ones. Nothing but content of R2 is copied to next 32-bit memory location. Now both are 8-8. And this way you have counted ones and zeros. Okay. Now you can change to any other number. For example, and stop debug. So keep in mind that you have to use only binary numbers. That's better to easy to count it. This is some random number I have given it. Okay. Now here how many number of ones are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6 ones are there. So of course remaining are 10 zeros are there. Okay. Now I'll save this one. Okay. Directly I'll run this one. Stop. Now you can observe that the content of R2 is 6. Because 6 ones are there here and 10 zeros are there. A is hexadecimal in nothing but in decimal 10. Okay, these two are stored in the RAM memory location. Okay, so this way I counted the ones and zeros. So how to write in journal now? So in writing journal, so this is your input. And of course, these are your output. So in writing output, you have to write this way only. Instead of mentioning the zeros, you have to mention 6 here. Here you have mentioned A. Because you can write in decimal only 10 also you can write. Because after counting, you will come to know that 0, 6, sorry, this is 10 and this is 6. After counting, you come to know that 10 number of 10 binary zeros are there and 6 binary ones are there. Okay. So this selected portion you have to write in your journal. Okay. This part you have to write in journal. Okay. Okay. So okay, I'll stop here. Okay. Now, in the part B program, all these are interfacing experiments. So we need the actual hardware interface board is required. We'll also demonstrate this with the help of video demonstration as I done this YouTube video. In the same channel, I'll upload the by after getting the evaluation board. Okay. Right now, I'll stop here. So we'll look into the part B into the next session. Okay. Thank you.